Oh. Well, I know it isn't, because of...
But it's one of the same ones.
Interesting. Okay.
Yeah, I've got the Elise software that allows me to program that. When I bought the bus, it was pre-programmed for Fairfield, but, you know, those destinations don't mean anything to me, so I did it over again. Make it up to Fairfield?
I think last summer I went up there after took my kids to the Western Railway Museum. We went out to the Fairfield Trans Center and shot photos for events. That's about it.
Do they still? Is it all Gillig up there?
Mostly Gillig. They do have some MCIs.
Oh. Okay.
Yeah, they run that for their commuter service.
Is it all run by MV?
Yes.
Okay.
Their commuter service goes to a couple of BART stations. They have like, the ops manager, well, my ops manager, who's with the BART Express now, he used to work at Fairfield, and he would go collect stuff. Like I said, he's seen like 30 links and 20 MCIs.
I wonder if they still have Phantoms in service.
Oh, yeah.
They do?
Yeah. Almost exactly like this one.
They seem to take pretty good care of their buses.
Yeah, they do. It's a suburban system, so there's not so much wear and tear.
Right.
Yes, it's a bus. So.
Back up. So your contact up there, they work for MV or the actual Fairfield?
Yeah. The first person I contacted is the maintenance manager for both the Mark Express and the City Transit.
Uh-huh.
And yeah, he was doing all the arrangements, but like I said, his sister passed away.
Yeah.
And then he had to take care of all that sort of stuff for a while. And then the operations manager for the Mark Express, who, I'm in contact with him constantly.
Yeah.
Because he used to work with Fairfield. And yeah, he was a big ops manager there, and he still lives in Fairfield, I should say. He commutes all the way from Fairfield down to the city.
Oh.
You know, so yeah, he's pretty familiar with their operations. Contest as the, I guess, the most driving time.
Oh, really?
Yeah. So he's got an hour and 10 minutes, so I'll probably catch up to him today.
I mean,
I only had 7 before right now.
7 minutes?
7 minutes, that's it.
Wow.
Yeah, 2 minutes in the flyer last year.
Yeah.
And 5 minutes in the flyer this year, that's it. This is the only second bus I've ever
driven. So you haven't driven? Oh, this is the second one?
Yeah, this is the only second bus I've ever driven. Yeah, so both times I drove 25-46.
None of the other guys are willing to let you partake, I guess?
No, it's just more confidence.
Yeah.
And the thing is, for me, I'm the type that I don't ask, I let them give me permission first.
Right. Well, that's actually good, because...
Yeah. I don't insist on that. But, yeah, standing invitations to drive 942 already.
Is that Fishbowl?
Yeah, that's one Scott's Chris Longbow.
Oh, right.
Yeah. So I'm standing invitation to drive that. Standing invitation to drive 1241 also, which is a Gold Beach Trans RTS.
What's your favorite bus?
For all time on the drive.
No, just like your preference of like New Flyer, Gillig, Nabby, RTS.
I don't have a preference right now. Probably not the RTS because it's not the bus of my formative years.
Yeah.
If I had to choose, it's probably the new look flexible, like the one you got.
The new look flexible?
Yeah.
Or the Metro?
No, the new look one.
Yeah.
Because Uni had a few when I was growing up.
Uh-huh.
And I rarely saw them in service, but when I did, it was like, wow, this is amazing.
Yeah.
And I never rode the AC ones, but I just don't think they're going to the AC old school colors for some reason.
Yeah, it's a neat bus.
So I'd say those, that one captures my imagination the most. But I grew up with Fishbowls.
Yeah.
That's all Uni had. Team leaders.
Right.
And of course, these are transactions.
Right. But,
yeah. So I'd say those two are one and two in my whole. Probably flexible one of those. It was such a rare catch for me.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, Joshua, don't you drive his TriMet flexible? Last week, just around the kind of around the block with the storage unit, but it's got some issues. It's got the transmission's leaking, which concerns me, which is a new problem. But then Eddie had the EPM override. Eddie had that rubber band on the switch so it would run, and then before I picked it up, Wanted Transit Systems overrode the switch, so basically there's no EPM protection. Right now, so something's going on that's causing the computer to shut the engine down, and right now it's overridden. So that I need to get that addressed, whatever it is. Plus, it's not registered or insured yet. So.
Okay, yeah, that's kind of an issue.
Yeah. I don't know if I'll keep that bus long term. I mean, I wanted to save it from getting scrapped.
Yeah.
I mean, there's other people that told me they'd buy it at some point if I wanted to sell it. It's a neat bus, but...
Do you intend to do anything to it?
What's that?
Do you intend to do anything to it besides maybe fix the transmission?
I mean, mean, it'd be nice to get it all cleaned up and probably not. I might change the signs back to the flip dot, the original flip dot. In fact, I've already ordered signs for it, but I'm not sure if I'm going to put them in immediately. The signs Eddie put in are Illuminator Horizon, which are nice, but they're not originals of the bus, and they're also, it's not the best installation I've ever seen. It doesn't have AC, which is a big...
Oh, it doesn't?
No.
Does it turn off or never take AC?
There's no AC in it. Here, you have no compressor, no system in it. There's ventilation and heat, but... Yeah, for some reason they didn't put them in that year, that for TriMet at least. I guess it's cool up there, so you don't really...
Yeah, it is. So the later ones do have AC?
Yeah, the 94s, I believe, have AC, and all the newer stuff has
AC. That's crazy.
I know it is. I mean, you know, even if my flexible, my old flexible has AC, but, you know, I'm not going to pay the $10,000
it's yeah, exactly.
cost to get it up and running again.
Can I make it between those?
You probably can.
Oh, yeah.
Not having an AC isn't that big of a deal, but I mean, if I have a newer bus, it'd be nice to have the option to have it working.
Well, the windows are low, too, right?
Yeah. It just gets so hot here during the summer.
Yeah.